Hi everyone, it's Beck here, and today I have a tutorial for you for the Swirlydoos Kit Club, featuring their December 2015 kit, All That Glitters. This kit features beautiful papers from the Kaisercraft Silver Bells collection, along with some amazing glittery embellishments and add-ons to go with it. To start this page, I actually unfortunately forgot to hit record on the video straight away. But all I've done here is I've taken two pieces of the Kaisercraft paper in Baubles and Good Wishes, and I've just cut the white one down a bit to stick it on top, just so you have that pink edge. The next thing that I did was I took some clear gesso and gave that a really good coat on the paper. I just used clear gesso to help it stop the mist seeping into the paper too quickly when I spray them. And so I like to give it a really good even coat, because I find if you accidentally forget a spot, because it's clear you can't quite see, that you get a funny pattern with your mists. So it's nice and even, and then I'll just dry it off with my heat gun. Once it's all dry, what I've decided to do for this page is take the wooden snowflake that was the Kaisercraft wooden snowflake that was in the project add-on kit this month, and use that as a template for my page. So what I've done is I've just holding it down and spraying it with two Lindy Stamp Gang sprays. One was Cotton Candy Pink and the other was Chateau Rose. And so I've just sprayed that a good even coat, and then when I lift it up, I was quite surprised actually, I got a really clear snowflake pattern on my paper, nice and white. So I'll just dry that off with my heat gun. So my edges aren't sticking quite well there, that's alright. And then next I've taken the snowflake paste that was in the mediums add-on kit, along with the Kaisercraft festive quarters stencil, and I've just cut it up into the four squares, and I'm using the snowflake one on this one. Now this snowflake paste is very, very pretty. It's got nice glitter in it, and when it dries you can see all the glitter shining through. So I've just put that on, now I'm going to dry it off with my heat gun. Next step, I've taken some of the Perlex mica powder in silver, which was also in the mediums add-on kit this month. I'm just mixing it with a little bit of water. I've taken a chipboard frame, just one from my stash, so you can use any sort of circle frame you'd like, and I'm just adding some of the mica powder to it. With this mica powder, if you put just enough water to make it wet, you get a really, really nice shiny texture on that chipboard. And then I'm just adding a little bit more water and putting some splashes on the page. Next up, I'm taking the Perlex mica powder in rose gold. Again, that's from their mediums add-on kit this month, and adding some water to that. So do a few splashes there as well. I do end up covering most of this up, but I just like some extra detail in my backgrounds. So I just dry that off before I start my next step. What I've done here is I've cut my photo down to a square, and also cut a square slightly bigger than it for backing. And I'm just using that glitter tape that was in the main kit this month to put around the edges. This tape, although you can't quite see it in the video, is very, very sparkly. It's so pretty. And so once my photo goes back on, you'll just see the edges peeking out. It goes on nice and straight too, which is really good. So I've just popped it on, then cut out any excess that was overlapping, and adhered my photo with some double-sided tape. And then I've just taken a doily from my stash to add on to as well. Been using doilies a lot lately, so I think they're my new favourite thing. I like my layouts to be quite 3D, so I'm just taking some cardboard and cutting it down to size to add on. So I've taken two pieces just so it's, because I like to get the flowers underneath the photo. So if you have two pieces of cardboard, you can kind of slot a flower under there quite easily. Next, I've taken some of the white Prima leaves that were in the flower add-on kit this month, along with some of the Petaloo mini burlap flowers, the pink ones. And then I've just added a few white flowers from my own stash on there. Now I'm just trying to arrange the flowers how I like, but I forgot the frame, so I just add the frame on first. So once that's glued down, now I start trying to figure out where my flowers are going to go. Generally, when I make these videos, I do pre-arrange the flowers just so I know how many to have out ready, but I still tend to move them around quite a bit until I get them just right. So once I'm kind of happy with where they're going, I start to glue everything down. Now I like this Aileen's tacky glue for this. I use it all the time, but it gives you the time to kind of move things if they're not quite where you want. It's not super fast drying, but once it does dry, it's very, very good. I make a little flower cluster, and then I'm just putting some leaves peeking out from underneath. These leaves are very pretty. They've got a nice glitter edge to them. Can't quite see it in the video, but very good in real life. So once I'm happy with that corner, I move up to the top corner. This is just to try and balance out the page a wee bit and have some symmetry. Again, I muck around here for a while with these flowers. And then I decide I need a little bit more pink up in that corner, so I just grab another one of these little mini burlap flowers, stick it down. These little glitter pegs were from the October 2015 project add-on kit that I had sitting around, but they went perfectly with this layout, so I just popped one on in the corner, a little bit of extra interest. Next thing I take is some of the pink organza ribbon that's in the embellishment add-on kit this month and tie it into a little bow to pop on my layout. And then I just trim off the edges once I'm happy with where it's sitting. Now I'm taking the that silver berry spray that was in the embellishment add-on kit this month, and I'm just cutting up little pieces of it. I ended up cutting this all up and using it on about three different projects this month. I just loved it. So it's great on a big item like this, just cutting it up and using bits as you need it. So I just tuck that in under my flower clusters there. I'm actually just cutting off little stems of three berries at a time, having them poking out. Then I'm taking the Kaisercraft pearls, the pink ones that were in the embellishment add-on kit, and adding them to my layout. I like to always add some extra glue to any pearls or rhinestones, even these self-adhesive ones, because I find they don't stick all that well for a long period of time. You tend to find them falling off after a while. So I just add a little bit of glue to the bottoms of them before I stick them on. And then they're stuck for good that way. I never have much of a kind of goal when I stick on pearls. I kind of just add them on randomly until I'm happy with how many I've got on there. And then finally for this one, I've taken the sticker sheet that comes with the kit. I think this is in the embellishment add-on kit this month, and just chose a couple of the word stickers to stick on. And again, I just put some extra glue on there, even though they are got adhesive on them. I don't find they stick quite well by themselves. And that is my layout finished. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today. And remember to go to theswirlydoo.com to see if you like any kits for yourself to order them. And also check us out on the Facebook gallery page and also on the Swirlydoo's forum. There's lots of great challenges every month for everyone to participate in. Thank you very much for watching. Bye.